Good day. The following video depicts Expert Field Medical Badge Evacuation Task Numbers 1 and 2. Evacuate casualties using one person carries or drags, and evacuate casualties using two person carries or drags. The video consists of the task grader talking through and performing the carries and drags selected for testing by this EFMB's testing board. Specific carries and drags selected may differ by location in accordance with current guidelines. Please note that uniforms depicted during standardization training differ from those required during testing by the EFMB Test Control Office. The video was recorded in April 2023, utilizing the June 2022 testing standards.
This is EVAC 1 and EVAC 2. This is evacuate casualties using one-person carries and evacuate casualties using two-person carries or drags. For EVAC 1, we have a support personnel. One of them will be acting as casualty. The other one will be playing the role of the candidate. So you can lay down. For task condition standards on EVAC 1, you're gonna evacuate casualties using one person carries or drags. The conditions: you are in an operational environment and have been directed to perform casualty movement. Your evaluator will provide a prompt prior to each carry. You'll need to execute the correct carry based on the evaluator prompt. You do not need to verbalize the correct carry, but you do need to execute the correct carry. Standards: perform casualty movements while adhering to all performance measures with 100% accuracy, utilizing go and no-go criteria. So, ready to begin. You're gonna walk up to the casualty. You're gonna ensure the casualty you're moving them that way.
Moving down to the end.
All right. At this point, I will state my cue. It'll be, this carry is used for moderate distances between 50 to 300 meters. As a candidate, you're gonna take a knee on the uninjured side of the casualty, verbalizing this step.
Take a knee on the uninjured side of the casualty.
You're gonna raise the arms over the casualty's head. You're gonna cross the furthest leg away from you, over on the ankles. You're gonna reach across, holding by the hip and under the armpit, rolling the casualty towards you. You're gonna straddle the casualty. As you straddle the casualty, you're gonna reach under their chest. You're gonna lift them up. Once you have them in a kneeling position, you're gonna interlock your hands for a better hold, and you're gonna prop them back up all the way until their legs locked out. Once your legs are locked out, you're gonna hold the casualty. You're gonna lift their arm up with your non-firing hand. You're gonna slide your head under their arm. Once the casualty is supported there, using your shoulder and your head to keep their left arm with you, you're gonna reach out with that hand under the casualty. Yep. Sliding under the casualty, maintain control of the casualty. Once there, you're gonna ensure that your M4 is not caught by the sling on your tap system. Once your M4 is free, you're gonna squat down, support the casualty's weight on your back, prop the casualty up, and transport the casualty 25 meters. All right, that's far enough. For the second portion of EVAC 1, you're gonna be waiting for the next cue. Next cue, the casualty is gonna lay down. You're gonna receive your cue. It's gonna state, this carry is generally used for short distances in combat. That's gonna cue you to start the neck drag. You're gonna straddle the casualty.
I'll take you down to the end. Are you conscious?
Yes.
I'm gonna have you extend your arms, and you're gonna interlock them around my neck.
Alright.
Are you able to kick your feet?
Yes.
Once I start moving, start kicking your feet, pushing off the ground.
Yeah.
Alright, that's good enough. 25 meters. At this point, you have ended EVAC 1. Going on to EVAC 2. Once again, you will be read your task conditions and standards. For EVAC 2, you will have one support personnel and one additional support personnel in the role of the casualty. For EVAC 2, you're going to be starting laying down. The task conditions and standards: evacuate casualties using two-person carriers or drags. Conditions: you're in an operational environment and have been directed to perform casualty movement. Evaluator will provide a prompt prior to each carry. You will need to execute the correct carry based on the evaluator prompt. You do not need to verbalize the correct carry, but you do need to execute the correct carry. You can serve as bearer number one or two, but must provide instruction to the non-candidate support personnel. Standards: perform casualty movement while adhering to all performance measures with 100% accuracy, utilizing go and no-go criteria. So I'll be playing the role of the candidate. This will be my support personnel. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna approach the casualty, communicate the plan with him. We're gonna move you, okay? Then the evaluator will state, this carry is used for long distances over 300 meters. He's gonna be in the position of bearer number one, so I'm gonna instruct him what to do. You're gonna approach the casualty's feet, you're gonna spread his feet apart, you're gonna place yourself between his feet, facing away from him, you're gonna bend down, and you're gonna reach behind his knees. I will place myself behind the casualty's head. I'm gonna reach down under him, propping him up, holding support of him. I'm gonna interlock my fingers. You ready to lift?
Ready to lift.
Lift. Once he's up, we're gonna start transporting him. We're gonna reach the 25 meter mark. We're gonna turn around. We're gonna come back down to the 50 meter mark. And then we're gonna set the casualty down. There you go. Moving on to the second portion of EVAC 2. Evaluator will state, this carry is generally used for moderate distances, 50 to 300 meters. The casualty will be facing that way, and I will instruct to my support personnel, come here, face this way, for camera purposes, face that way, this way, do as I do. You're gonna interlock your arms right here with the thumb inside of your forearms. You're gonna mirror the support candidate's form. So come here, you're gonna interlock at the forearm, interlocking at the forearm. You're gonna place these behind the support casualty's knees whilst communicating with him. When you feel her arms behind your knees, you're gonna reach behind her shoulders to support yourself. Ready, lift. Then we're gonna transport the casualty out 25 meters, turn around, come back 50 meters, place the casualty down. That'll be the second measure. Third measure, you're gonna hear the cue. You can lay down. This carry is used to move a casualty for short distances. This is the two-arm seat carry. You're gonna approach him on the opposite side of me. You're gonna take a knee as I do. Reach out your arms as I do. All right, what you wanna do is switch arms, right? That way they mirror the support. You're gonna interlock, holding either at the forearm or closer to the wrist for a better hold on him. The casualty is conscious, so do not forget to communicate the plan. Hey, can you raise your legs a little bit as we reach under? All right, we reach down. We have him right here. We're gonna say, hey, can you prop yourself on our shoulders?
Yep.
All right, reach over. And we got him right here. And then we're gonna prop up to a knee. Ready to lift?
Ready to lift.
Lift. We got him up. We're gonna move 25 meters. Reach the turnaround point. We're gonna come back 50 meters. Set the casualty down. And that completes everything for EVAC 2.